it's the day before I start my keto diet, so I just thought that I would talk to you guys a little bit about how I've been preparing and why I'm doing it. So basically, I decided about 2 weeks ago to do it, and since then I've been doing a lot of research and just trying to add more protein and fat into my meals and decrease the carbohydrates so that it wouldn't be such a shock to my system next week. So I've been having yogurt with my breakfast. Today I just had eggs for breakfast, eggs and cheese, and then yogurt and fruit with some flaxseed and cinnamon. I've slowly taken out the honey in my yogurt, which honestly today, I'm not gonna lie, it was not even good. Yogurt with just cinnamon and flaxseed, it's missing something. I'm also having my matcha, which I'm very happy that I can still have, but I had to decrease my sweetener in that as well. I used to put brown sugar in it, and then I started putting just honey and vanilla, and today I just had it with vanilla, and it's fine. It's fine. Maybe I can work up to doing bulletproof matcha. We'll see if we can make that a thing. So yeah, that's kind of what I've been doing to prepare. I'm hoping that it's not too much of a shock, because I didn't want to just be on the floor next week at work. I also basically stopped eating dessert, because I used to have dessert after lunch and dinner, and after dinner I would just eat at least one dessert or just snack. And last week I stopped doing that, and I actually thought that that was gonna be the hardest thing about keto, was not having something sweet after dinner. But it was really not that hard to stop doing it, actually. I think because we didn't have anything in the house. I just finished up what we had, and then we didn't make any other dessert. My mom and I really like to bake, so there's always something around. But last week, I just didn't make anything else, so there wasn't anything to have. At first I was oh my god, I'm craving something sweet right now. I need something sweet. But then by the third night, I was okay, we're just gonna move on with the evening. So I thought that was gonna be the hardest thing. But I actually think, there's two other things that I'm thinking are going to be the hardest part. But let me rewind and explain why I've decided to do it. It's two things. I had my 26th birthday recently, and I also had a doctor's appointment. And on my 26th birthday, it just hit me how many things I want in my life to be different by the time I'm 27. There are so many things, but one of them is my health. It wasn't something that I had really been consciously thinking about, but I knew that I didn't feel well most days, and then all of a sudden I became way more conscious of it. Most days I just don't feel well. I have a constant headache. I have one right now. It's right here. And I do think that this could partially be sinus allergy related, so I have doctor's appointments lined up for that as well. But I also do wonder if it could be, all connected. But I basically have a headache all day, and it just goes in and out of being worse or tolerable. And right now I can tell that it's also a lot from lack of sleep. I slept garbage last night, so my head can hurt from not getting enough sleep. It can hurt if I sleep in. It can hurt from eating breakfast. It can hurt from not eating breakfast. It can hurt from eating lunch. It can hurt from going too long without eating. It can hurt from wearing a headband. It can hurt from wearing a high ponytail. It can hurt because the pressure changed outside and it's raining. It can hurt because I'm congested. It feels like it hurts from literally anything, really no rhyme or reason. But I do notice that I don't feel super full after I eat normally, and I'll be hungry 2 hours later, or I won't feel energized after I eat. And so that's what I'm really hoping that this makes a difference in, because yes, I do kind of snack from boredom at work, because I'll just be I'm so bored, I just want to get something from my snack drawer. But it's not just that, it's because I'm not feeling well, and I know that if I have a little bit of sugar or something, it's going to make my head feel better, or my alertness feel better for a minute. I don't know if that makes sense, but it's I just need something to make me more alert. It's not just that I want the taste. I don't think that's really the problem. That's something I can get past fairly easily. It's the fact that I feel like I'm constantly in this fog. And when I have, something that has carbs or sugar in it, it makes it better for a minute. And I think that's what the cycle I've been on. Because of course it doesn't help long term. But yeah, that's kind of the backstory there. And then at my doctor's appointment that I had, which was just to get referrals for the other specialists that deal with the allergy stuff, the PA seeing me was like, "You're so young," when she was looking at all my health problems. And I was like, "Yeah, I know." And it just hit me. I was like, this is not good. Like, I've had people say that to me before. Basically, I have IBS and ulcerative colitis, and I've always had stomach problems, like, since high school. I've dealt with very, very bad digestive issues, like debilitating, awful digestive issues. And after college is when I couldn't take it anymore. Like, senior year of college, I almost didn't want to finish because I also was having headaches, brain fog, just awful, awful, awful bloating. I could barely function. And I did try going gluten-free. I was vegetarian all through college, which it turned out was a major problem because of my IBS. All those foods I was eating, like the legumes and the cruciferous vegetables, were just making it worse. After college, when I saw a functional medicine doctor, I stopped being vegetarian, started eating more foods again. I went on the low FODMAP diet, an elimination diet, which was so miserable. So I was off of gluten, most dairy, sugar, and like everything else, like all the FODMAPs, and you introduce them like one at a time. And ever since then, I've just been basing my diet around what my stomach can digest. And because I can't have really any legumes, cruciferous vegetables, like that knocks all of that out. Wheat wasn't a trigger for me, so I continue eating that. And I stopped being able to digest any really high fiber foods at all. So no quinoa, no brown rice, like anything like that. And so all that was left is refined carbohydrates. And so I knew, like, no one thinks that's good for you, but I thought that I just had to keep eating like that because it was the only thing that my stomach could digest. And I knew that it was just a temporary solution, but I was like, this is what's working for me now, and I'm just so busy, like, I don't have time to deal with this, like, I don't know what could even be done to fix it. But I'm realizing that I think, you know, eating all those processed foods is what has caused the inflammation in my body that is making it so hard for me to digest things. The main reason I'm doing this is for my headaches. Like, my digestion is not terrible right now. I'd say it's like, I give it like a C. It's way better than it was in college. Like, that was so miserable. Never want to go back to that. Like, it's manageable, but if this could improve my digestion, that would be great. But I would consider it a success if it improved my headaches. Like, I just constantly feel like I'm in a fog, and like, I will sometimes have like a couple hours of clarity for the day, and I know it never lasts, and the fog is gonna set back in, and I just don't wanna keep living like this. And this is coming from someone who loves sugar, who loves baked goods, like, so much. I think that you just have to like hit a point where you just can't keep living the way you were living, and that's what I've hit right now. So going back to the things that I think are gonna be hard about the diet are, I'm afraid that I'm going to feel worse. I know that I can do it. Like, I've been on like restrictive diets before, like the elimination diet I talked about. I know that I can like go without sugar. Like, I can do it, but it's like the not feeling okay and not having any way of making it better. So that's what I'm worried about, is that I'm going to be on this diet and having these like restrictive limits and still feeling terrible with nothing to fix it. Caffeine always helps though. And I'm not taking that away. Just no more Starbucks matcha or strawberry acai lemonade. And you know what? That's fine, because I'll save money. The other thing is just how long it takes to prepare the foods. Like, I feel like with working 40 hours a week, I just never have time to do the things that I want to do. I spend my evenings like exercising and getting ready for the next day. And it's really scaring me to think how much more preparation this is going to take. So I'll kind of take you through that. Today I'm going to be making egg bites to take to work for breakfast. Because like, what am I supposed to eat at the office? Like, I can't just make eggs, you know? So I'm gonna be making that, but I hate preparing food. And I also have to track, I'm going to be tracking it for at least like the first month to see, you know, my macronutrients and everything. And that's gonna be a hassle too. Like, I just wanna eat the food, especially when I'm hangry. Like, just get me the food. I don't wanna have to like measure it out before I eat it and all that. So I think those two things are gonna be the hardest. Okay, so that's basically where I'm at right now. Day before starting keto, I have awful headaches where my whole face hurts, right here, brain fog, digestion problems, IBS, ulcerative colitis. I'm on anti-inflammatory meds for my ulcerative colitis, and I also take Excedrin, so I'm honestly worried about the function of my liver at this point, even though I don't drink because of how many anti-inflammatory meds I take. That's where we're at right now. I will update you as we go.